What's good, Tinania family? Welcome to another reaction video! Proud to be Samoan. And seeing things like this, you know, you think of your parents and you think of your great grandparents and keeping the tradition alive, even though I was born in Australia. Peter, suck your baby, yo! And g'day guys, welcome to another reaction video. Yo, I am really proud and excited to be doing this reaction video. Lately I've been seeing a lot of tubers putting up their bea, which is traditional men's chief tattoo. Really excited and proud to be showing you guys how this is done. I've come across this really cool video created by one of these guys, have had the privilege and journey to their bea, which is tattoo. If you're new to our channel, thank you very much for subscribing. Please don't forget to press the like button. Ding, 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 ding. Go ham on it, go ham on. Also, please press your notification bell, which looks like something like this. Ding! So you're notified every single time we post up a video, which is what, people? Every single day, oh, we on the grind every single day. Some people say to us, how do you do it? Mate, it's just passion. And if you're gonna do something, don't talk about it. Do it, yo. Like, Sale Sunga, pick up the camera. All right, so, as I said before, this guy has been on an awesome journey of his tattoos. And you know, I'm so proud to be Samoan, so proud to be Polynesian. And if you haven't heard of Polytubes, please go ahead and press in the search engine, ding, Polytube, and you find out every Kiwi, every Polynesian, every Fijian, every Tongan, every Samoan, every Hawaiian, every American that's doing YouTube. Please go and follow them. Show them some love. Show them some love, guys. Each tattoo, each line has a meaning. Each village has its own patterns. Each family has their own meanings behind their patterns. And I'm gonna take you on a journey with this brother, showing how proud he is and where he comes from and the reason why and how we do the better.
I went to Samoa to get my tattoos done. It's something that I've wanted for a long time. When my dad suggested it to me 20 years ago, ever since then, it's been on my heart. What does it mean to be tattooed? As I've grown into
the way I've gone through life.
It really became heavy on my heart that this needs to be done as part of my journey. Having lost the Samoa altogether in my teenage years,
now Samoa, look at that water, guys.
I'm beautiful. Ready to take on what a Samoan man is supposed to do.
Guys, look at Samoa. Samoa is absolutely beautiful.
I was born here in 1969. Not too far away from this place. That's your brother Sunny. And then we lived in the plantation out at Saleimoa. The whole point of us going to New Zealand, my parents always fed it to us from the very beginning. They wanted me to focus on education. That they stopped me from speaking Samoan. I think they said it to everyone, but I thought they were saying it to me, and so I was the only one that obeyed. I grew up being called the Pālangi of the family because I didn't know any Samoan.
A lot of our parents, like my parents, migrated to New Zealand from Samoa, which was an awesome privilege as a family member back in the days to be sent to Samoa. Do you remember that? I remember my dad saying everybody will wait on the radio and wait for their name to be called out, or their family name to be called out from the lulu on the radio. So what lulu means is, it's like a raffle, I think it is, and they on the radio, everyone's waiting because there's sponsors that they do every single month or something like that. I don't know if they do two or three Samoans out there, please correct me. Both my parents had the privilege of being sent to New Zealand for that same reason, for the better life, to send money back to Samoa. But you know what? As we watch this, I say to my parents, man, Samoa is absolutely beautiful. The land is free, food is free, the water is beautiful, the land is beautiful, and the only thing you need to pay for, you know, really, is power. That's it. But you know, that's me looking from the outside in as a Westerner, and my opinion on it. Going back to Samoa and seeing how they live, it's very Westernized. But there is so much land out there that they could be doing that among us, which is their plantations, and selling it and getting it back for money so they can buy food, or doing their plantation and eating from the plantation. I don't know. What do you think, guys?
By the time I got to high school, I completely lost the language, completely lost the culture. And in that place, I kind of trying to figure out, well, you know, who am I? I had what was to me at the time, everything that was important to a teenager. I was popular, I was well-liked, I was smart. Between school and my parents, not quite feeling like I belong in either world. And in those dark places, I thought the answer would be to kill myself. The first time I chickened out, the second time,
depression is real, guys.
The bar that I was going to hang myself on broke. But that dark place led me to an encounter with God that completely changed my life. And it helped me to start again.
Amen, brother.
And,
amen.
And in that encounter with God, I asked him, who am I that he should keep me alive? And the thing that God showed me was, what is the most obvious thing about me? And the most obvious thing about,
for so many of us islanders as well, we have been growing up with the church, which is an amazing thing. You know, God is good all the time. God is good, yo. You know, Christianity in our islands brought us faith, brought us encouragement and something to believe in. Not that, you know, our culture wasn't enough, but I think in our days, God is so important in our lives. That's my opinion. God is so good, absolutely amazing. And as the brother has said here, actually saved his life and opened his eyes to a better life where he is today. Let's keep watching, guys.
About me was my brown skin. So I guess that was my cue to restart and to find out who I am, was to find out what it meant to be brown, what it meant to be Samoan, what it meant to be someone born in Samoa, raised in New Zealand, and that was...
Sorry to stop again, guys. I just wanted to briefly give my opinion on what he was saying there is, you know what, parents are giving us a better life and stuff, and, you know, in Australia and New Zealand, we're very grateful. But at the same time, we have to remember where we come from. And what I'm seeing nowadays, especially on the Polytube vloggers, yo, there's a lot of us generation going back to Samoa, building the homes, restructuring things in Samoa. And you know what? That's absolutely amazing. This generation that has been growing out of Samoa, going back to Samoa to reignite our roots, to show the world and our children how proud islanders we are. No matter if you're Samoan, Fijian, Tokelauan, American Samoan, Tongan, any Polynesian, New Zealand, gotta be proud from where we're from and always speak up for our rights, y'all.
My rebirth, so to speak, that was a chance for me to live again, start again, but this time make more deliberate decisions.
Pretty cool, eh, guys? Look at Samoa, my little fat. Yes. Yummy, yeah. Oh, look.
And then there's two roads you can go down, right? Accept it or fight it. You fight it, you're in trouble.
The contradiction is the more you fight it, the worse it hurts. Just like golf.
And the more relaxed, the more, not relaxed, but the more you can receive the pain and let the pain be there, the better the tattooing process. Not that it's going to take the pain away, but just...
So they're just talking about the process and the pain that he's going to go through. I'm not sure if he's a tattooist, but I think he's just telling him, think about his roots, think about his culture, think about where he comes from, think about things that have happened in the past. It's all part of the journey. And that's why some of these tattoos take from 7 days to 3 weeks, up to 3 to 4 weeks to get these tattoos done. Because it's basically from your waist, covers your butt, down to your, just above your knees, I think, or past your knees. So that's a big, big, massive process. Let's keep watching.
Straight out of when you finish a session, you'll have to sit under a shower, and they will massage you. And that is, oh man, now that's a pain. That's a pain in the butt. That one.
Yeah. So that massage out. Oh man, each session. You need to prepare.
I'm excited.
Yeah,
I've been looking forward to this for a long time. This day has been a long time coming. I didn't expect to be like this though.
He's a bit nervous.
Really looking forward to today.
I was getting emotional too.
I also know my body.
And you know what? I was watching some other guys, you know, that have theirs done in New Zealand or done in Samoa or here in Australia, in America, on YouTube. You know, it's an emotional ride. Not because I don't think it's the pain. I think you start to feel proud of where you come from. I'm getting a bit emotional. You get proud. You're proud to where you come from. Your dad's come from. Your mum come from. And it's part of the culture that you've seen on your uncles and your aunties if they get the women's one. And you know what? It's quite an emotional ride. And I feel that emotion as a guy to another guy getting it. I've got tattoos all over my arms, as you guys see in our vlog. But that's different. That's a different pain. Not that I've had it done, but I can feel their pain when they're getting it done. And the emotional pain. That's what I'm talking about. Sully, stop talking. Oh.
He's about to go through some extreme pain. So not that I don't think you can ever be ready for it. Pain. But... yeah, so nervousness, excited, emotional.
Yeah.
You know, this is a huge sentimental journey to this day. So, and this is that day.
Yeah. Getting ready, guys. Unless they look like needles, are they needles? Here goes, guys. It's all starting. Just to let you know too, I know some families sit around, the women sit around and start singing songs, and there's a few people, as you can see, are gathered around you to give you the encouragement. But I've also seen the village women come and in rounds, because it takes hours and hours and hours to sing song after song to encourage you. And you know what? I'm getting a little bit emotional talking about it, because I'm just proud where I'm coming from. I'm proud to be Samoan. And seeing things like this, you know, you think of your parents and you think of your great grandparents and keeping the tradition alive, even though I was born in Australia. Peter, suck your baby, yo. You know, it's our tradition and culture, you cannot run away from. It runs for your veins, bruh. It runs for your veins. See all the men? There's a few men sitting around and encouraging him on. Damn! But you gotta be very special. You gotta be specialized at this, sorry. Hello, bro. I've seen that too. There's always two wipers. They wipe it down as he's going. Wow. I think that was his day one. Look at Samo, beautiful. Yeah, that was day one. He's smiling. I think he's going back for day two. The faleo oyo, faleo. Paper Samoa. This is what they're talking about. Shh.
Whenever God took the people of Israel or select people through something,
massaging it through, as I said before,
took them through a particular difficult period, he always got them to mark the occasion so that they would never forget. And I guess for me, spiritually, these marks are to remind me of my journey so that I never
must
forget.
Must be a special leaf.
As I research the
it's part of our medicine to help it heal.
I guess these marks
mark him as a proud Samoan. My little brother.
The reason why I'm here is this September marks the
getting emotional.
This September marks the 25th anniversary of the day my life changed. September the 21st, 1987. I celebrate that birthday more than any other.
And God saved me.
More than my physical birthday, because that's the day I started to live
God
again.
Bless you, bro.
And so, it was important to me to get these tattoos. And I guess in many respects, it's a graduation for me. But also, there's this Samoan saying, a proverbial expression, and what that means is that all the streams have gathered at this waterfall, and I guess this is the waterfall that...
And you know what? It's funny, the older we get, I don't know about you guys, but the older I get, we try and get closer and closer to our culture and to our islands and wanting to know more about the history. When we were younger, it's, you know, you with your friends and you're like, whatever, mum and dad, freshie, y'all. Whatever, freshies. But as you become a parent and as you become more familiar, stories from other families, your family, the bond tends to get closer. You always come back to it. Always come back to your roots.
Every aspect of my life points to
tell us
what you give is what you get. But yeah,
So he's talking about how he comes up with the tattoos. As I said before, you have elements from your family, elements from your country or island, and elements from water, elements from stories, elements from your nana, elements from your other uncles that had it done, merge it together, and it makes it you, makes your better more interesting. That's pretty cool, eh? And that's what I love about it. They never, ever do the same
tattoo.
Kakao is another word for bear, or tattoo. Proper word saying. So they come around on the side, the rib part. Ah, on his ribs there. A very personal thing, isn't it? And it's a story that you can pass down to your children as well. And show them patterns of, oh, this means this, that means that, and that there means this, and this here means that, and that here means this in my country. You know, it's all different meanings. I think his one went for about 3 weeks. Yeah, after 3 weeks of traditional Samoan tattooing, Sunny returned to New Zealand. So it's taken him 3 weeks.
The tattoo is finished. The book is the last part.
Which
to
is
be
your belly
tattooed.
Button. Belly button.
So when he said lying on the back, I thought, oh, it's the last part now. And I just put my head back and I just cried.
Yeah.
Cried for 5 minutes nonstop. And the helpers, they kept my dignity. They just sat there, didn't say anything, they just let me go through it. And I've got these beautiful marks to show for that
well
journey
done,
to remind
bro. Look
me
at that,
of where
that,
I've come
that looks
from
amazing.
And to help me find my way as I move forward. Having come back with my tattoos has really impressed on my heart that
that's
my declaration to the world that I'm a Samoan and I'm proud of it. If everyone's the same, then what do we lose in order to become that, whatever that is? And so I like that we are different.
Yeah.
I like that there is no one else that wears marks like these. I like
that, guys.
The mandate that's written on my body.
Wow, proud Samoan. Well done, bro.
And I like
the history
and the heritage that comes with all of that.
That's the history,
so,
bro.
Part of the better for me is about making a declaration.
Yeah.
I am Samoan. I'm not ashamed of it. I'm very proud of it.
Cheers.
And as a Samoan man in the 21st century, here's what I want to do with my life for the Samoan cause. I may be insignificant. I may come from nowhere.
Looks awesome.
And as small as I am, I can still make a big impact. And so I'm determined now more than ever to make that impact. It's done and it's marked on me, lest I forget.
Yeah. Mālo, bro. Cheeeehoooo! Did you like that, guys? I felt this video very, very inspiring when I saw it about 6 months ago, and I saved it. And I was just going through my reaction videos and thinking, what do I want to do? What do I really want to share with you guys? Something a little bit different. I know we tend to do funny ones, but I just want to share with you guys how important it is to keep your culture close with you, wherever you're from. If you're from London, if you're from Australia, if you're Aboriginal, if you're American, if you're Indian, if you're Samoan, if you're Tongan, if you're Polynesian or New Zealand, be proud of who you are, guys. Just want to let you know, those traditions have been going on for years, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you guys enjoy that. All right, before we say goodbye, guys, I want to show you something. That is the iPhone that we are giving away to one special winner. Yes, one special winner. I'll quickly play a quick clip of our giveaway.
Subscribers, that's really good.
Thank you.
Alright, here is your prize.
Oh! Oh! Oh my God!
That's our giveaway, guys. I know, go and watch it. There's a few rules before we put it into the draw. One, gotta be a subscriber. Two, gotta press the notification bell. And three, you gotta comment down below. Hashtag to none of your family. Hashtag to none of your family. Cheeeehoo! Oh, I'll link it up above here, guys. Or that side or this side. Anyway, there'll be a card up here somewhere. Go and watch it now. It's free, man. It's a free giveaway. They're the only three things that you need to do, guys.
Welcome. It's time for our shout out.
Alright guys, it's time for our shout out! And our pinned comment is ding! And the special shout out goes to... Yay! Please guys, go subscribe to these guys. I think they've just subscribed to us. And you know what? Thank you very much guys from wherever you're from. We're gonna check out your page. Thank you very much for commenting on yesterday's video. We pray that God blesses you on your page and your journey on YouTube. For all our comments, keep them coming guys. Keep them coming, we love it. We love responding back to you. We thank you for sharing the love. And you know what? Don't forget to go to this page. Ding! So you can find out every Polytube channel that's out there. As I said, I think we liked another 2 today and 10 yesterday. So that's 12 together. There's these pages that are coming up on Polytube movement. And the admin for that, shout out to them. It's the Tuiloma Clay. What's up, guys? Thank you very much. I found out that you guys are the admin of that page yesterday. I was like, who runs the page, guys? Much love from your family. And if there's three things you'd like you to do, that's it.